Welcome to Hofstra Today. We spoke with a Hofstra Earth Studies professor, J.B. Bennington, about a plant potting event in honor of Earth Day.
We also sat down with the University Psychology Club about their organization and some upcoming events.
And later we have a special performance from my dance team, Transcend Dance.
All that and more at and around Hofstra Today.
Welcome back to Hofstra Today. I'm Gabe James.
And I'm Caitlin Bancroft.
Caitlin, can you believe that we are finally here? It is your last show, and how are you feeling?
I honestly haven't accepted the reality that's my last show. I mean, you know, I've been a part of this since my freshman year. So have you. So has Amelia. We've all worked so hard to get to where we are, and to finally be sharing my last show with you feels like fate, because I've been wanting to work with you for so long. So I'm happy to do this show. Let's kick it off.
I'm so excited that you're here. So let's get into today. What's going on at and around Hofstra? The New York Metropolitan Pen Show will be held in the David S. Mack Arena on April 22nd and 23rd. The event will feature over 75 tables with all different kinds of vendors. These tables will include both vintage and new fountain pens, custom nib grinding, journals, inks, and wax seals. Tickets are $12 for one day and $20 for both days. More information can be found on the Hofstra Events calendar.
The Department of Global Studies and Geography presents Pathways to Peace on Thursday, April 27th from 11:30 a.m. to 5:45 p.m. at the Guthard Cultural Center Theater. There will be a panel analyzing the historic Good Friday Agreement to commemorate its 25th anniversary. The symposium will feature multiple presenters discussing current challenges facing Ireland and Northern Ireland. The event is free, but advance registration is required.
Meet the Office of Commuting Student Services and Community Outreach for their World Fair, presented by the Commuted Student Association and Student Clubs. This event will celebrate many cultures with different foods, music, and performances. The event will be held from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. on April 26th in Pride Park.
The program director of Hofstra's Master of Arts in Forensic Linguistics, Dr. Robert Leonard, is hosting a webinar to discuss a homicide case he took part in solving. This event will challenge students to look for clues throughout the case and even read a letter he analyzed as evidence. He will also discuss different internship opportunities with the Forensic Linguistics Death Penalty Innocence Project. The event will take place April 28th at 12 p.m. Students must RSVP on the Hofstra Events calendar.
On Friday, April 28th, the Department of Music is hosting the Hofstra Choral and Chamber Choir Concert. The concert, directed by David Freiling, is titled Perchance to Dream. Hofstra students can attend for free with proof of their Hofstra ID. The price for general admission is $10. This event will be held at the Cathedral of the Incarnation in Garden City at 7:30 p.m.
April is National Poetry Month, and to celebrate, WRHU is holding a poetry cafe. The event will feature reader and Hofstra professor Gail Teller, along with several other WRHU staff members, and will be held followed by an open mic. This event will be held in the content suite in the Lawrence Herbert School of Communication on April 20th from 6:30 to 8 p.m.
The Office of Graduate Admission is hosting a webinar to discuss the pre-medical post-baccalaureate certificate program. The webinar will go over the application process and program overview. This event will take place on Tuesday, May 2nd at 5 p.m. The program is available to students who have a bachelor's degree in a non-science related field to help prepare them for entrance into the medical field. Advanced registration is required on the Hofstra Events calendar.
On Tuesday, May 2nd, the Assistant Professor of Engineering and Graduate Program Director, Dr. Brian Galley, will be hosting a webinar on Hofstra's Engineering Management Masters of Science program. The event will talk about the admission process and highlights of the 30-credit program. There will also be a discussion of careers in the engineering management field. The event will be online at 12 p.m. Students can RSVP on the Hofstra Events calendar.
On Saturday, April 29th, the Women's Diversity Network and Hofstra University are hosting the annual Diversity Summit. This is a welcoming event for people of all cultures, ethnicities, and genders to come together. The WDN has partnered with community members, established nonprofit organizations, social groups, service-based groups, and leaders of newer awareness-raising groups to make this event possible. The event will also feature diverse and enriching dance, music, poetry, and storytelling. The event will take place in the Sandra and David S. Mack Student Center from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Admission is free for all Hofstra students.
The Department of Music is hosting the Levin Honors Recital on April 29th at 4 p.m. in the Helen and Fortunoff Theater in Monroe Lecture Hall. The concert will feature Adriana Garacio and will honor accomplished undergraduate music performing seniors. The event is free and open to the public.
Hofstra Psychology Club holds weekly meetings centering around a variety of mental health related topics. Members can partake in various activities such as creative arts therapy and service dog training. We spoke with the club's executive board to learn more about their organization and some of their upcoming activities. Let's take a look.
My name is Isabella Herrera. I'm the president of the Psychology Club.
My name is Ashley Miller and I'm the vice president of Psychology Club.
I'm Victoria. I am the treasurer and social media chairperson for the Psych Club.
My name is Bianca St. Ange, and I currently hold two positions on the e-board for Psych Club. I am the secretary, and I am also the fundraising chair.
My favorite part of working with the Psychology Club is truly building community with the different students that join our club and working with our amazing e-board. We dedicate so much of their time to making the club what it is.
My favorite event that Psych Club has held so far is the Paint and Sip Night. It was something that we haven't done in a while since COVID, and it was just nice to unwind and also socialize with other psych majors.
I think Psych Club benefits my education and major because it helps to reinforce what we learn, like in the classroom, and helps to introduce new ideas and topics outside of it too.
You don't need to be a psychology major to join. I'm a psychology minor and I actually hold an e-board position, so there's no requirement like that.
Join us after the break to hear from Alexa McNulty with our national news.
Hey you, yeah, you.
Have you ever wanted your work to be featured on live TV?
Then Director's Cut is the show for you.
But Katie, how do I apply?
It's easy, just follow these three simple steps.
First, go to our Instagram at Director's Cut HU. And while you're there, give us a follow.
Next, click the link in our bio.
Finally, select the guest submission form and send us your best work.
All submissions are welcome, from your 27s to your senior films.
Now over to Alexa McNulty with our national news.
Fox News settled their defamation lawsuit with Dominion Voting Systems for $787.5 million. Dominion alleged that Fox News knowingly spread disinformation about the company. Dominion lawyer Justin Nelson says that the settlement amount, quote, represents vindication and accountability, end quote. 16-year-old Ralph Jarl was shot twice on Thursday night, including once in the head, while going to pick up his two younger brothers. The Kansas City teenager suffered life-threatening injuries and, after being released from the hospital, is recovering at home. The shooter, Andrew Lester, turned himself into authorities on Tuesday and faces felony charges of first-degree assault and armed criminal action. The Air Force began an investigation into a leak of classified documents this past Tuesday. Airman First Class Jack Douglas Teixeira allegedly accessed and posted hundreds of classified documents online. He has been removed from his intelligence mission assignment and was arrested by the FBI. The Air Force is focused on creating and implementing new security procedures. That's all for your national news update. I'm Alexa McNulty. Now to Amelia Sack interviewing Transcendence Dance members.
Thanks, Alexa. So we are here today with the president and vice president of Transcendence, Lena Koos and Hannah McDonald. Ladies, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having us.
We're really happy to be here.
So tell us a little bit about what Transcendence is.
So Transcendence is one of the many dance organizations on Hofstra's campus. We pride ourselves on being non-audition based,
meaning anyone, if you're able to like make the time that our practices are, can come and learn some pieces by our own members and just sort of have a fun time. Anyone can sort of come and try it out.
Yeah, sounds like a great, easy way to get involved on campus. So what kinds of styles of dance do you typically do?
So we're all student choreographed organizations, so we do every type of dance from hip hop to lyrical, anything that any one of our student choreographers wants to bring in, we always try it.
That's great. So what kind of things do your rehearsals entail? Obviously a lot of dancing, but what else do you guys look forward to?
So we typically start off with a warm-up. Sometimes it's like more cardio or core strength based if it's like a really high intense piece. But sometimes if it's a little more laid back and relaxed, we'll do sun salutations. So it kind of depends. And then after that, we typically learn 1 to 2 dances put on by our wonderful student choreographers. And then we'll just keep practicing it. And then we will like record it so that way our members can either practice it at home, or if someone wasn't able to make it to practice and they still want to learn it, they can.
That sounds great. So why should people join T-Dance other than the reasons you already listed?
Yeah, so obviously we're a non-audition-based group, so it's really a come-as-you-are. We are non-judgmental to any kind of previous dance experience you might have, so it's really just an all-inclusive environment, so you can come as you are.
That sounds awesome. Now, I know we have some performances coming up. What are we expecting here?
So our soonest performance that we have is going to be with the Hofstra Concerts Music Fest. That will be on April 29th. And then after that, we're cranking out a bunch in May. We are doing a performance with the drag show on May 3rd. We have one with the NAACP charity performance, and that's going to be on May 6th. And then we have our own showcase that's going to be Wednesday, May 10th at 8 p.m. in the John C. Adams Playhouse.
Well, it sounds like you guys have a very busy schedule, but we want to thank you for making the time today to join us. And I know we have a performance here coming up on Hofstra today. So what are we expecting to see there?
So that's just essentially going to be some pieces that we've done just sort of in the past, as well as like, you know, bringing in some new energy with our current e-board.
Nice. What kind of, have you both choreographed any of the dances that are coming up?
Yes, so the second piece that we have in our show today actually was one that I did myself. But Hannah and I have both been in it for all 4 years, so we've choreographed a bunch over a while.
Yeah. Were you guys dancers before this, or did you just start dancing when you came to Hofstra?
Yeah, so I've been dancing my whole life, but T-Dance definitely got me into a lot of, you know, different kinds of styles, which is awesome.
I was not only dance in high school.
Wow. Well, it was so nice to hear a little bit more about Transcendance and a little bit more about you ladies today, but we're actually looking forward to a performance right here on our show. But for now, we're going to send it back to Gabe and Caitlin at the desk.
Don't go away, we'll be right back with this week's weather update.
When it's Thursday night and you've got nothing to do, we got a little show that you can get into. Get your coat on, put your vape pen away, see the funniest thing that you'll see all day.
We've got Skylar, Emily, and Dustin, Soad, and Jake. Look out for Jade and Richie's Thursday news break.
Yeah, there's twiggles, jiggles, giggles, music, sometimes cocaine.
I love meth!
Mob therapy, adultery, and spilling champagne.
If you don't watch TNL, you're going straight to somewhere bad.
Let's hear from Athena Dawson with this week's weather update.
Thanks, Gabe and Caitlin. I'm Athena Dawson, and this is your 5-day weather forecast. Right now, it's a cloudy afternoon with sunshine expected later into the day. We can expect a high of 61 degrees and a low of 41 degrees. Thursday will bring more intervals of clouds and sunshine throughout the day. Temperatures will reach a high of 64 and a low of 42 degrees. Now let's take a look at how the rest of the week will take shape here in Hempstead. On Friday, we can expect the temperature to increase of high of 73 degrees with a UV index of 7. On Saturday, you can expect mostly cloudy skies with winds reaching 15 miles per hour on Sunday. On Sunday, we will see heavy rainfall with temperatures peaking at a high of 63, so be sure to have your umbrella ready. That's all for the 5-day weather forecast. I'm Athena Dawson. Back to you, Gabe and Caitlin.
This weekend, reporter Kara Rosler had the opportunity to speak to Professor J.B. Bennington about Earth Day activities around Hofstra. Let's see what Hofstra's doing to prepare.
Hi everyone, I'm Clara Rosler, food reporter for Hofstra Today, and I'm here to talk with Professor J.B. Bennington about plants. Happy Earth Day, and let's get our gloves on. So what led you to like make this event or lead this event today?
So this past week, Hofstra has been observing Earth Day. And so this event is culminating outdoor events for our Earth Day celebration. On Wednesday, we had a whole bunch of panel discussions. We had some guest speakers on campus talking about sustainability. And now we're out at the student garden, kind of starting to get the garden ready for planting vegetables. Some of the vegetables get planted here. We give some of them away to people on campus. And the rest of the vegetable seedlings will go to the Roosevelt Community Garden in Roosevelt, New York, which is just south of campus. There's no planet B, right? We don't have any options. We gotta take care of this one, because as David Bowie, as Elton John said, Mars ain't the kind of place to raise your kids.
So what would you say Earth Day means to you, since you came out here to help with everything?
Earth Day is a day that you can appreciate this planet, the nature, and when I came and moved to Long Island, I saw a lot of trash, honestly, and it made me really sad. So Earth Day to me is eliminating trash, appreciating the nature.
If you're watching this and you want to get involved, you can contact the LEAF Club on campus, the Leaders in Environmental Activism and Fellowship. You can contact me in the Department of Geology, Environment, and Sustainability, and we will make sure that you know about these kinds of events and that you have the opportunity to come out and help and get involved.
After the break, Maddie Greenberg is bringing us into the week's Hofstra Entertainment News, so don't go anywhere.
Hey guys, it's me, Isabella Gomez, filling in for Smokey Bear, because he's got more to say than just...
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Like, if you're outside enjoying a barbecue, don't let a hamburger distract you from fire safety. Make sure you aren't dumping your hot coals or ashes onto the ground, because that could start a wildfire. So take wildfire prevention seriously, and let's save the world one day at a time. Juntos con Smokey Bear, podemos hacerlo. Go to smokeybear.com to learn more about wildfire prevention.
Let's toss it over to Maddie Greenberg with this week's entertainment stories.
Thanks, Gabe. Hofstra students can't stop raving about the Department of Drama and Dance's show, Dyke. The show had a fantastic opening weekend, and if you missed out on it, don't worry. There are still four more performances running from April 20th through the 23rd at the Spiegel Theater. Tickets are free for all, and pre-registration for non-students is required, so be sure to check it out. This spring, Hofstra Concerts will once again be holding the Famous Music Fest. Join Hofstra's own Official X and the Nice Guys as they open up for some of the biggest names in music, such as Cupcake, OMB Peasy, and of course, the headliner Ski Mask with Slump God. The event is Saturday, April 29th from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. It's free for Hofstra students and $10 for alumni and guests, so be sure to get your tickets today. The Hofstra Department of Music is hosting a brass ensemble concert on Sunday, April 23rd. The concert is directed by Michael Saltzman and will be held at the Helene Fortunoff Theater in Monroe Lecture Hall. No advance registration is required. The tickets are free and open to the public, so don't miss out. I'm Maddie Greenberg. Back to you, Caitlin Gabe.
The time has finally come for our special guest, Transcendance, to perform. I'm so excited.
Could you love me? The only one that you need.
750 Lambo in the Utah snow. Trunk in the front like a shit Dumbo, yeah. Cut the roof off like a nip tuck. Pull up to the house with some big bus. Turn the kitchen counter to a strip club. Me and Dre came for the. When I got guap, all of y'all disappear. Before I drop Sony, none of y'all really care. Now they always say congratulations to the kid. And this is not a 40, but I'm pouring out this shit. Used to have a lot, but I got more now. Made another hit, cause I got bored now. Always going for it, never pump fourth down. Last call, Hail Mary, Prescott, touchdown, hey. 100 bands in my pocket, it's on me. 100 deep when I roll like the army. Get more bottles, these bottles are lonely. It's a moment when I show up, God, I'm saying, wow.
Good morning. Probably into the early morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I live a fast life. Yeah, you know I live a fast life. I don't got a type, baby, I'm a cash type. Still getting dividends from a past life. I get your daddy's net worth on a bad night. Cause I act right. Yeah, rockin' red, clappin' ass leads like the 80s. Never give it up until the Reaper come and slay me. Pull up with a Zelda and a peach and a daisy. I be dirty dancing, now the yelling gravy Swayze.
Damn, baby, you so vicious, you so clean, so delicious. How come you ain't got no misses? Count that paper.
Never take an L no more. Never take a damn thing slow.
From sunlight to moonshine, you'll always be mine. They don't understand like we do.
Wonder boy, interplay in my vicinity. We are the synergy, yeah. I see the way that you walk in the center, this thing's illumic and we're
eyes in the
back,
never be
slap.
Energy,
sweet, feeling me.
Where you moving, it amaze me, darling. You're the baddest, how can I deny it?
Baby, it can roll it, ooh, on the, and we, yeah, smoking Honda, roll it.
Backing it up, I'm the queen of talking shit. Then I'm backing it up, yeah. Backing it up. Throw that money over here, cause that's what it's for. Said I was getting some, getting some. Ran down on a bitch, she almost put on her leg. Just think they f***ing with me, must be sick in the head. Why don't you chill with the beef and get some chicken instead? Got the crown, shut it down, had it hype up in the six. If she dead, let her lay, won't bring no life into this. Looking this good should be a sin. You should call me Cinnamon. Cardi B, bad bitch, those is f***ing synonyms. We see who winning, we see who got it. You see I'm still in the bank, making deposits. You see who switched up sides and who was solid. You see who stuck to the code and who forgot it. Talk about it.
Thank you so much to T-Dance for that amazing performance. And thank you for sitting down with us. Make sure to attend Terrence and Dance's Spring Showcase, May 10th at 8 p.m. We'll be right back with Jason Wank's Sport Update.
Sports beats, get your sports beats, only a dollar. Dre, my man, how's it going?
What are you doing?
Selling sports beats for a dollar, you want one?
Sure. Let me see. Oh, I got a dollar.
Here you go, my friend. Enjoy. Sports beats. Get your sports beats. Only a dollar. Get them now. Sports beats here. Get your sports beats here. Kate, Willie, can I interest you guys in a sports beat? Only a dollar. Here you go. Oh, fine paying customers. There you go, my friend. Enjoy, you guys. Yes. Sports beats. Get your sports beats here. Only a dollar. Only a dollar. Sports beats.
STEM is everywhere, like here, behind the scenes of The Walking Dead. STEM can create new worlds on and off the screen. The only limit is your imagination. Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
Welcome back to Hofstra Today. Hofstra's very own dance team has been chosen to represent the United States at the 2023 ICU Worlds as the U.S. National Pom Team. We spoke with our head coach as well as some team members to hear about their experiences preparing for this competition. Let's take a look.
Please welcome from the USA, the U.S. National Team.
I'm Sarah Ng, and I'm here with the coach of Hofstra's dance team, Kelly. How are you doing today, Kelly?
excited, nervous, anxious, happy, everything.
And what is it like coaching on the national level?
Coaching on the national level is a wonderful experience. I was on the team myself many years ago, and we were a national team then. So one of my goals when coaching the program was to continue to grow it to the next level, and we've been able to achieve several national titles since then. So just being able to push these athletes, motivate these athletes, really get them to be good people, strong people, champion-minded, all comes along with going on the national level, and it's the greatest experience.
What was your reaction when you found out you were competing in Worlds?
So we were actually at a local competition and we were setting up to take a team picture, which is very typical for us. And Coach Kelly was like, okay, on our next one, we're gonna say,
US National Team! What? Yes, you are! Yeah!
And so it's really fun to have a video of that to look back on because we all immediately knew the opportunity that we were given and what a privilege it was.
Do you have any lucky charms for when you're competing?
Just my best friends that are beside me, they really keep me going. So, you know, you always want to be perfect and some days they're just not going to be your day. But my friends and my best friends remind me that we have those days and just to keep going, that we're all there for each other.
This summer, for our summer camp send-off, we decided to face a different direction. We just had a feeling and we really didn't know why at the moment. And when we set the floor up and we were looking at the floor, we're like, oh my God, the American flag is right behind us. So it was almost kind of a weird foreshadowing because here we are now representing the USA.
Thanks, Sarah, for that report. We here at Hofstra Today wish the best of luck to the dance team as they perform this week in Orlando. So much to be proud of there. Now let's kick it on over to Jason Weick for this week's sports stories.
Hello, sports fans. I'm Jason Weick. Last week, the weather was hot, but the Hofstra Pride were hotter as baseball, softball, men's and women's lacrosse all went undefeated on the week. Let's take a look at some of these stellar performances. First, the diamond. University Field was rocking as the Pride swept the Towson Tigers in three straight. The offense was churning on all cylinders as they won 14-10, 7-4, 13-zip. Now, speaking of that 13-0 contest, it helped Brad Camarda earn CAA Pitcher of the Week as he tossed complete game shutout, striking out six, walking just one. Now, across the parking lot, softball followed suit as they brought out the brooms against the Hampton Pirates. They took care of business, winning 8-2, 4-3, and 11-6. Alana Morris received CAA Co-Rookie of the Week as she batted 4-for-12 with a .333 average and a team-high 4 runs and 3 RBIs. Don't worry, we didn't forget about lacrosse. The women's team upset Elon 17-12 in a shootout on Sunday afternoon. The effort was spearheaded by Megan Flannery, who had a career-best 6 points, tallying 3 goals and 3 assists. The men's team won a huge game versus Drexel 8-7, and Tim Hagedy took home CAA Co-Defensive Player of the Week after his career day that saw him recover 4 ground balls and 3 caused turnovers. That's all for this week's sports update. I'm Jason Weick. Back to Caitlin and Gabe.
We hope you all enjoyed this week's episode of Hofstra Today. Thank you for watching. And a very special thanks to our guest, Trance and Dance, for their performance today. Make sure to follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and our TikTok at Hofstra Today for fun video updates. For the very last time, that's all at and around Hofstra Today.